Hello, welcome back. So now in this part, we will solve an analytical problem to understand the flick beam. So in this, this is the problem that we have to solve. In this, we have to determine the superimposed UDL the flick beam shown in the figure can carry. And the effective span of the flick beam is 5 meters. And we have to assume that it is in the inside location. Now, beside this, because there are steel plates, so the data for steel plates are also given. So unit weight of steel plate is 78.5 kilonewton per meter cube. And the value of ES, which is Young's modulus of elasticity of steel. So the value is 2 into 10 raised to power 5 newton per mm square. And permissible stresses in bending in steel is also given, which is 16.5 kilonewton per centimeter square. And the wood which is being used for the beam is of Devdar tree. So Devdar tree wood is used in the timber section. So this is the cross section of the beam. And if we try to make the 3D diagram of this, so it will something look like this. So say these are the plates, and plates will run through the length, something like that. And they will be supporting on a support. So the effective span of the beam is given, which is 5 meters, and the dimensions for the beam is also given, like the thickness of plate is 1 centimeter and the width of timber beam is 15 centimeter and the depth of steel plate and beam, timber beam is 25 centimeter. So these are the data. So now we will start analyzing it. So basically in this, what we have to find out, this beam is actually supporting a UDL. So we actually need to find out what will be this UDL value. And this UDL will be exclusive of self weight of the beam. So as you see, this UDL is per unit length. So at one unit length, what is the this UDL excluding the self weight of plate and beam? So for that, what we have to find out, we will be using the concept that bending moment, I mean maximum bending moment, will be equals to the moment of resistance. So moment of resistance can be calculated by bending equation, or if we have the data to calculate the maximum bending moment, we can easily calculate that. And so here we will see how we can calculate it. So first of all, if we want to find out moment of resistance, so we know that bending equation is to be used, which is M by I, F by Y. I think these two terms are enough. So in this, we have to find out M. I can be calculated, why? Because the dimensions of the cross section is given. So we can easily calculate the value of I. Similarly, Y value can also be calculated. And we know that Z is I by Y. So we actually have direct formula to calculate MR that we have derived in the previous part. So we will be using the same formula directly to calculate the MR value, and then we will compare that with maximum bending moment to calculate the W value. So that is the process that we are going to follow. So in this, first we have to see what is the permissible bending stress and permissible bending stress in the timber and in the steel. So first we will see permissible bending stresses and modulus of elasticity of timber and steel. So here we are using the Devdar wood for inside location. So here we have to find out FB, permissible bending stress in the Devdar wood. So we can find out that using the table, permissible stress table. So here, this is the table. And in this, we have this Devdar wood. And corresponding to this Devdar wood, we have the bending column, this one, and we are actually using this beam for the inside location. So corresponding to Devdar, we have the FB of timber as 10.01 Newton per mm square, because it is in MPa. So MPa and Newton per mm square are same. And also Young's modulus of elasticity in the third column. So in this, it is given in kilonewton per meter cube per mm cube. So for Devdar, the value of E is 9.32 kilonewton per mm square. So with the help of this table, we can find out these values. So FB of timber is 10.01. With the help of table, we are able to find out it. And Young's modulus of elasticity of the timber is 9.32 kilonewton per mm square. So we can even convert this into Newton per mm square like this. So this becomes 9.32 into 10 raised to power 3 Newton per mm square. So as we have found permissible bending stress and modulus of elasticity for timber, we will also see what is these value for steel. So bending stress in the steel is already given in the problem, which is 16.5 kilonewton per centimeter square. So we have to maintain all the units uniformly. So here we have the FB value in Newton per mm square. So we also need to convert this in Newton per mm square. So by converting it, we get the value FB as 165 Newton per mm square. So in the steel, maximum permissible bending stress is 165, while in timber, maximum permissible stress is only 10.01 Newton per mm square. Similarly, the value of modulus of elasticity for the steel is also given in the question, which is 2 into 10 raised to power 4 kilonewton centimeter square. So the same value can also be converted into Newton per mm square, which becomes 2 into 10 raised to power Newton per mm square. So these value will actually be used in the calculation of moment of resistance. Now, because this beam will be carrying a definite W, and because of that W, there will be bending stress, which will actually be actual bending stress. So here we have to check whether this dimension of the timber beam is sufficient, or if it is compatible with the steel plate of this dimension. So therefore, we have to see what will be the actual bending stress, and to be compatible with the steel plate, this FAB should be less than FB of timber, which we have seen, which we have found from the permissible table. So that we will be doing here. So here, as the steel and timber will be deforming together, therefore at extreme fiber strain in the steel is equal to strain in timber. So that is what the assumption we have used to formulate the moment of resistance formula. So here, the same assumption we are using here, strain in steel will be equal to strain in timber. So here, FB of the steel is here, we already have E value, and this E value for timber is already we have, but here we will actually be replacing this with the FAB, because we want to see if the required, if the provided size is compatible with the given size of plate. So therefore, we will calculate what is the value of FAB by using this relation. So actual bending stress in this case would be FAB of timber is equals to E timber into FB by E. So putting all the values in this, we get the FAB value as 7.69. And you can see FB of timber is 10.01 Newton per mm square. So what does it mean? FAB value, actual bending stress in the timber, will be less than permissible value. So therefore, we can say that this size of timber beam is compatible with the given size of steel plate. So now moving to the next step. So here we will calculate the moment of resistance. So moment of resistance formula we already have formulated in the previous part. So we will be using the same formula. So this is the formula that we have formulated in the previous part. So moment of resistance for this case of beam is given by this formula. So in this we will put all the values FB of the steel. Here actually we will be putting the value bending stress value of the steel, but here instead of FB of timber we will be actually putting the actual bending stress in the timber. So therefore it is FAB which we have calculated in the previous step. So putting all the values in this, we get the moment of resistance as 46.39 into 10 raised to power 6 Newton mm. We can also convert this value into kilonewton meter. So in kilonewton meter the value is 46.39 kilonewton meter. Now as MR of the beam is calculated, now we will move to the next step in which we are required to find out how much UDL the beam can support when we add the two steel plates on the sides. So here we will be using the same concept. Moment of resistance of the beam is equivalent to the maximum bending moment, and we actually have this beam, like if I draw this in the line diagram. So this is our beam in which it is carrying W. So basically maximum bending moment for this beam will be at center, and that maximum bending moment will actually be WL square by 8. So we will actually compare this with the moment of resistance of the beam that we have calculated in the previous step. So here equating both of them, so MR of the beam is 46.39 and maximum bending moment at center is given by WL square by 8. So here L value is already given, which is 5 meter for the beam. So putting the value, we get the W as 14.845 kilonewton meter. So this W value is 14.845 kilonewton per meter. But you know, this value is including the self weight of steel plate and timber. So therefore we have to deduct the self weight of beam per unit length from this UDL, and then only we will be able to see what is the external UDL which it can carry safely. So therefore we will first find out the self weight of the beam. So superimposed UDL the beam can carry, it will be represented as W dash, and W dash is equals to W minus self weight of beam. So W value we have calculated now. So here we are required to find out self weight of beam. Now in the self weight of beam we have steel plate and we also have timber beam. So we have to find out self weight of beam per unit length. So here per unit length can be considered as per meter, because load is in terms of kilonewton per meter. So at 1 meter length, what is the self weight of steel plate and timber? So to calculate the weight, we have the formula volume into density. So volume of plate multiplied by density of plate, steel plate, plus volume of timber beam plus density of timber beam. So here I am writing volume of timber into density of timber. So this density of timber can be calculated or can be found from the permissible stress table, and volume of steel plate I will write here, volume of steel plate for a unit length, steel plate will be something like this. So this thickness is 1 centimeter, and say this is unit length, say unit length is 1 meter, and the depth is 25 centimeter. So ultimately volume becomes L into B into H. So L is 1 meter, B is basically the thickness. So thickness, all values should be written in terms of meter. So 1 centimeter in terms of meter will be 0.01 meter multiplied by the depth. Depth becomes 0.25. So that becomes the volume of plate per unit length multiplied by the density of steel. Now density of steel is already given in the question, which is 78.5. So unit weight of steel is sometimes we use in calculation which is synonymous to the density. So it is volume multiplied by density. Similarly, for timber also, we will add this with timber self weight. So for timber also, length is 1, width is width of timber beam will be I think it is 15 centimeter. So width is 15 centimeter, 0.15, and depth is 0.25, multiplied by density of timber. So density of timber is to be found from the table. So in the table you can see here, this is the Devdar wood and density at 12% moisture. So density is given here, which is 5346 newton per centimeter cube. Actually this unit is actually for the density. So by mistake it is printed here, but it is actually for the density of second column. So the unit is 5346 newton per centimeter cube. So we have to convert this value into kilonewton per meter cube. So we can do that. So ultimately this will become 5 point. So I have solved here. So you can see here the calculation. So this is the W value, self weight of timber, which is length multiplied by width multiplied by depth multiplied by density. Density is 5.346. We have directly converted that 5346 newton per centimeter cube. So we can convert this value into kilonewton per meter cube, which becomes 5.346 kilonewton per meter cube, which we have written here. Similarly, for steel, length of beam is 1 meter, width or thickness is 1 centimeter. In terms of meter, it becomes 0.01, and depth of steel beam, which is 0.25 meter, and unit weight of the steel, which is 70.8.5. So calculating this, we get the UDL, which can be supported on the timber beam, which is 14.25. So that is our answer. So this is the UDL which our beam can support externally. So that concludes our numerical, and that concludes our lecture. So we will continue our discussion in the next lecture. Thank you.